It was the penultimate day of action at the Winter Universiade in Granada. Medals up for grabs on snow and ice. It was Russia against Canada in the women's curling final. The snowboarders hit the piste in the slope style. Look out for the 1,000 metres short track action from the igloo. And a battle royal in ice hockey between Canada and Russia. Friday saw the final of the women's curling competition at the Fuente Nueva Pavilion. Defending champions Russia took on Canada with a gold medal at stake. Canada led by Brianne Meakin, certainly starting as underdogs. Coached by Doug Kreviazuk, team included Lauren Horton, Lynn Kreviazuk and Jessica Armstrong. Meakin attends the University of Manitoba, her teammates Carlton Ravens. Action here from the third end. Canadian team making its Universiade debut. Although Meakin was an alternate in 2013. Russia 7-2 in the round robin. Opened the game with a steal against Canada. Russia led 1-0 after the first end, but Canada bouncing back. A deuce in the second, and they stole three in the third for a 5-1 lead. 10 teams entering this women's competition. Norway, Great Britain, the USA, Japan, Spain all had negative records and were eliminated. Canada beating Switzerland 8-3 in the semis. Russia too strong for Sweden in a 10-4 success. So it was tight early on and perhaps signs of a surprise. Into the sixth end. Canada had won all their nine preliminary games before that win against Switzerland. Russia showing their experience. They were 5-1 down after the third end. Sidorova, though, able to hit for a three of her own in the sixth to cut the lead to a single. Meakin couldn't roll her shooter in the seventh either. And had to settle for a single. Sidorova won Universiade gold in Italy, bronze in 2011 in Erzurum. And at just 24, Sidorova, certainly a big name in the world of curling. Canada had beaten Russia 9-7 in the preliminaries. And in that game, Canada led 6-3 after six ends and held off a Russia comeback. Sidorova drew for a game-tying deuce in the eighth. This was when Russia, starting their comeback, and they stole a crushing point in the ninth as well. At the end of the eighth, it will be 7-7. Experienced Russian team led by Sidorova, Margarita Fomina and Katerina Galena playing for their fifth Universiade, having won four previous medals. This getting to the business end of this final. Eighth end will be 2-0 for Russia. The ninth, 1-0 into the 10th end. Canadians managing to push the defending Universiade champions all the way to an extra end. Meakin drawing for one in the 10th to force those extras. And what a final this was to become. Really exciting stuff. Going into an extra end. The 11th end then, the team that represented Russia at the Sochi Olympics did just enough to take gold. Sidorova able to make her final shot for a second straight Universiade gold medal and a 9-8 victory. This the decisive moment. And a victory for Russia. Canada getting their fourth medal in Universiade women's curling play, third silver overall. Russia proving just a little bit too strong, and that extra experience coming through. Sidorova competed in the last two Winter Olympics for Russia and most recently finished third at the World Women's Curling Championships in St. John in Canada. There you have it, a tight win it was for Russia. 9-8, the final score after 11 ends. Desperately disappointing for the Canadians. Thought they might go home with the gold. They'll have to take home the silver with Russia, the favourites, again, the champions in Universiade curling. Snowboarding action continued at the Sulia Snow Park, and the women and men both in action in the slope style. This discipline has gathered in momentum in recent years. It was part of the Olympic program for the first time in 2014. So in Spain, there was soft snow, about 0 degrees, nice sun as well, good conditions. 15 competitors in the women's, with 9 countries represented. Judges from Austria, Slovenia, Bulgaria, Switzerland, the Czech Republic and Germany. Let's take a look at Marion Erti from the Institut Universitaire de Technologie in Annecy in the French Alps. Her best run was the first one. All the competitors having 2 runs. So Marion Erti here. This enough to get her the bronze medal. 77.75 points. Marks of 76, 85, 75 and 75 being counted. Remember, the top and the lowest mark discounted for all of the athletes. Snowboarders taking 2 runs, the best run counting. Athletes judged on the height of jumps, degree of difficulty of the tricks and execution. Marion Erti delighted with that performance that would get her the bronze. The USA represented by Courtney Cox. It was her 25th birthday on Thursday, and quite a way for her to celebrate, because she would take a silver with this performance. She reached the quarterfinals in the snowboard across. Student at Colorado Mountain College in Breckenridge in Colorado. This her first run as well, and it got her a silver medal. 80.25 points after marks of 82, 79 and 2 of 80. So great work there from Courtney Cox, and she'll be making a long journey back to Colorado with a silver medal in her pocket.
5 points for Courtney Cox, top of the rank.
Let's have a look at the winner though, Celia Petrik, will be 20 this month. She studies at the Petrik EHSM Swiss Federal Institute of Sport in Maglingen. Her best run was the second one. Bit of pressure was on her, and she really performed well. She came fifth in a half pipe earlier in the week, and this performance quite easily giving her the gold. In fact, 90.25 points. Fine performance from her. 2 scores of 90. 3, in fact, and 1 of 91, giving her that excellent score, 90.25. She's putting 10 points better than Courtney Cox, the silver medalist. Michaela Davis-Meehan of Australia got 4th. Ramona Petrig of Switzerland, 5th. But it was Celia Petrig taking the gold for Switzerland with that super performance. They have it then. Switzerland top of the podium, USA second, France with the bronze. To the men now, and I remember a couple of years ago, Switzerland took gold and bronze in the slope style, and this time another Central European nation would dominate. 17 competitors from 8 countries, altitude a little under 2,600 metres, vertical drop 162 metres with 3 jump features. Here's the bronze medalist, Martin Mikiska from the University of Economics in Prague. Disappointment in the halfpipe, but made up for it here. Mikiska scoring 82.25 points. Two 82s and 80, an 85 in there. And that would mean a bronze medal for the Czech competitor. Four snowboard disciplines, half pipe, parallel, giant slalom, snowboard cross. What a great improvement for the Czechs in the slope style. Mikiska doing the job. There you see his results, 82.25. This is Piotr Janos from the School of Form in Poznań in Poland. He got his first medal of the Universiad 4 years ago in Turkey. Very poor weather forced the cancellation of the slope style, but conditions very good in Spain. And Poland would get the silver, Piotr Janos, 87.75 points. On his second run, including 3 marks of 88 in there. Fourth would go to Russia, Mikhail Matviev. Fifth for France, in the shape of Matteo Kuni. This is the silver medal performance, Piotr Janos of Poland.
Top three. Slop style final, snowboard slop style final of the Winter Universiade 2015.
Here he is, beep number 14, Piotr Janos. So Janos good, but not quite good enough for the gold medal. That went to this man, Petr Horák from the University of Economics and Management in Prague. So another medal for the Czech Republic and his first medal, taking the gold that was won by Filip Hani of Switzerland 2 years ago. Rafał Imhoff picked up the bronze in Italy for Switzerland. And it was to be the Czechs dominating here. Petr Horák, a display of real power and athleticism. And he would take gold. Again, quite comfortably, 92 points, his average mark on the second run. With two 92s, 194 and 190 from Austria. Super performance it was from him, and what a day it was for the Czech Republic. Mikiska getting the bronze, and Horák here with the gold medal performance.
We're on the 55th position of the FIS rank. So this is bib number 12, Peter Horák.
Spectacular stuff indeed. And what a day it was on the slopes for the Czechs. Horák first, Janos with the silver, and Mikiska taking home the bronze. Short track speed skating, one of the most spectacular events at the Winter Universiad, and fans at the Igloo in Granada had plenty to look forward to, the men and women competing in the 1,000 metre event. Track little over 100 metres in circumference, so little room to manoeuvre. Starting with the women's events, 3 of the 4 finalists from South Korea. This is the one from Europe, the number 24, Anya Sarakati from the Lithuanian Sports University in Kaunas. She had the 500 metre bronze earlier this week. From South Korea, Alan Kim from the Korean National Sports University. Hakyung Song from the same university, and Eunbol Lee from the Korea University in Seoul. Alan Kim, number 19, Eunbol Lee, number 20, Hakyung Song, number 22, with the Lithuanian 24. Now, Alan Kim, already the 1500 meter champion this week, relay gold medalist in Sochi, silver last year's Worlds in Montreal, the favorite. Eunbol Lee, had a 1500 meter silver this week, so in form as well. And also a 1000 meter silver 2 years ago at the Universiade, Vancouver Olympics, 1500 meter silver, another real candidate. Hak-Yong Song, 500 meter silver this week. It was always going to be tough for Sarah Katty, the Lithuanian. She was at the front of the pack, but with three teammates behind her, she was the underdog. Sarah Katty, one of the top Europeans ahead, but it wouldn't last too long once we got to the business end of this 1,000 meter event. So it was Kim Lee and Son of South Korea getting ready to overtake Sarah Katty from Lithuania. It was a brave attempt from the students from the Lithuanian Sports University. But the Koreans would hit the front, and there was a wonderful battle between Alan Kim and Eunbol Lee to come. The pace quickening. The number 19, Kim, and the number 20, Lee. And that's how it finished. So a second gold this week for Alan Kim. She stopped the clock in 1 minute 37.321. Eunbol Lee, second with the silver. And Hankung Song getting the bronze. Tough for Sarah Katty, who finished fourth. 3 years ago, China winning all three short track individual medals with the women. This time, South Korea dominating. To the men, and it was an all-Asian final. Two Koreans, one Chinese skater, and one from Japan. Si-Yung Park and Yira Seo from South Korea. Gyung Chen from China. And Hironobu Murataki from Japan. Si-Yung Park from the Dongkuk University. Already the 1500-meter champion this week. Former world junior champion, but he crashed out of the 500 meters, you may remember. Yira Seo from the National Sports University, already the 500-meter champion in Grenada, so one of these going for a double gold. Chen Guang, though, also there from the Chengchun Normal University in China, and a bronze in the 500-meter and 1500-meter, so he was looking for a third medal. Horonobu Maratake, the outsider here, from the B final in the 500 meters from the Kanagawa University. Guang Chen moving to the front on the third lap before Yira Seo hit the front. You see a slip towards the end, letting in Si-Yung Park, the number 77. Two teammates know each other very well. Yira Seo, the number 78, looking in a good position. But Si-Yung Park is a fine competitor, and tactically he got it just right. Into the final stages, and there you see it. Si-Yung Park hitting the front, and no one was going to stop him. Two gold medals for him this week. This, the 1,000 metre. So a 1-2 for South Korea. Si-Yung Park, gold. Yira Seo, silver, and China getting the bronze. Guang Chen, his third bronze of the week. But South Korea dominating, Park and Seo, the 1-2. Two ice hockey powerhouses went head-to-head in the men's semi-finals, with Canada playing Russia. The Canadians had beaten Russia 5-3 in the group stage. They knew their opponents were out for revenge. Both of these teams had won their quarterfinals without giving up a goal. Canada beating the USA 4-0, Russia outclassing Slovakia 7-0. So a top-class match in store. Russia's goaltender Sergei Belov. Canada, it was Christopher Lazaruk keeping goal. Canada under the helm of David Adolf. Russia coached by Vyacheslav Uveev. This was going to be a tight game throughout. Early on, a chance for Russia's Oleg Lee. Then a goal for Russia. Jesse Craig dispossessed, and Ivan Petrakov taking full advantage. An early strike for Russia. midway through that first period. And at the other end, Craig tried his luck, thwarted by Sergei Belov. Russia had a chance with Timur Shingarev going close. It stayed 1-0. Canada had a chance with Levko Kopa. That was missed. And after the first period, it was looking good for those young Russian fans. Into the second period, and a good save there for the Russian goaltender again. Then a strike for Canada. Levko Kopa after the initial shot from Cody Cartier. Canada right back in it. You could see what it meant to their young players. The champions in the Universiade looking for gold again here. Midway through the second, a power play chance for Russia. Artem Fedorov just wide. Canada had chances of their own. Cruiser Redick coming up here. Oh, expected a close game. That's exactly what happened. Two teams here very much looking for gold. Russia having a shot here with 9 minutes left in the second period. Rushan Rafikov. So into the third. And within a couple of minutes, a goal for Canada. The initial shot from Neil Manning and Chris Collins credited with the goal. But the lead wasn't to last. Russia's Timur Shingarev, Mikhail Klimchuk with the assist, and the Russian fans enjoying that. It was back to 2-2. Another save from Belov, one of 37 on the day for the student of Ryazan State University. Six minutes left, Canada had a chance, Taylor Foster, but another save. There were chances in the closing minutes. Foster with the chance. And right at death, the Canada goalie, Chris Lazaruk, showing his worth at the end of the period. He made 31 saves. And that meant nervous fans waiting for overtime. Now, 2 years ago in Italy, Canada beat Russia 2-1 in the semis before beating Kazakhstan in the final. Craig went for broke, but again, the Russians keeping Canada at bay. And this one will go to a shootout. Canada would miss Chris Collins. Disappointment for him. At the other end, Russia scoring. Sergei Barbashev making no mistake. Canada really under pressure. After that strike, it was up to Taylor Foster. A disappointment for him. And Russia sealed the deal through Shingarev. Delight for the fans. Russia through to the final and with a chance of gold. Barbashev and Shingarev, the heroes in the shootout. But desperately disappointing for Canada, who are not going to retain their gold medal at the ice hockey in the Winter Universiade. What a game it was then. Petrikov and Shingarev with the goals for Russia. Kopper and Collins and the shootout heroes, Berbashev and Shingarev. Russia into the final. Canada, at best, will have to play for the bronze.
education meets sport and culture. What best promotes excellence in mind and body? Where do friendship, integrity, and achievement meet? Which event gathers the best student athletes from around the world? The Universiade, the home of international university sports. Today's stars, tomorrow's leaders.